Hi everyone, I'm coming. I'm just a bit late. Won't be a sec. Hello. Hi everyone, sorry I'm late. I'm like 5 minutes late, my goodness. Welcome to a Scribble Brigade. Welcome to my studio slash office. Hope you're doing really well. I'm seeing lots of really cute messages and familiar names and sweethearts in the chat. Thanks for being here. So, I think today is going to be a little bit of an experiment. I have had this idea floating in my head for, I'm going to say like a year at least, of creating like a cabinet of curiosity together, but with like drawings, like a drawing game where a random thing will come up on the screen and we draw it in like 2 minutes or something like that. I don't know. So I've been on Pinterest and I have gathered heaps of funny little vintage trinkets and just funny little bits and bobs, some plants, some like old keys, some jewelry, some vials of things, just like a bunch of random vintage curious goodies. And I thought we could just like give it a go. So I've got my sketchbook in front of me and I've got some Prismacolor pencils in front of me as well. Feel free to use whatever you have on hand. Whether it's ink, you want to go a bit risky and a bit wild, go ink, which I think will look awesome and be really fun. Brush pens, crayons, texters, pencils, collage, I don't know, whatever you feel will be fun. That sounds really good. Debbie, hi Debbie, I'm obsessed with finding weird little random ceramics and bits and bobs on Pinterest to draw, so this is perfect. Oh, so glad. I am, here's Bibi. I love collecting random things. Like, I love vintage stuff. I love collecting funny little bits and bobs and vintage jewelry and just like funny little trinkets. Here's a baby snoot, do you see? So, I don't know. This is like right up my alley as well. So, I'm glad I also love. So, if you don't know what I'm talking about, a curio cabinet is. I don't even know if that's the name of it or anything like that. It just feels right. So let me show you. Something like this. This is the deal that I am going for. You know, this is what I think a curio cabinet should look like or is in my brain. It's one of those like, you know, those old letterpress. It's like an old letterpress drawer where all the little letters and stuff would have been. and people have just gathered little things and put them inside these little drawers. So I think they're super cute. I love this kind of thing. I love weird random stuff. Even stuff like this, which is just far more grand and interesting and crazy and weird. Yeah, so that's the deal. I thought what we could do, okay, I have a couple ideas for us. Either you can get your piece of paper and like cut up a bunch of like squares and rectangles and funny little shapes, and then you've got like a pile of squares and rectangles and shapes that you can like grab and draw on. That's actually maybe a good idea. Maybe I'll do that. And then what you can do is you have all your squares filled with all your goodies that you've drawn, and then you can like arrange them on your page and create your own kind of curio cabinet. Yeah. Digital art also. So you could like draw like a grid situation. You can always come back and like fill it in later, but you can draw a grid and then with your, you can just like with different layers, put different things inside your little grid. Yeah. What do you reckon? You can make your grids really clean, really measured, or you can just go a bit wild. I'm going to quickly go grab a piece of paper to cut into squares. Just give me a little secky-doodle here. What have we got here? This might be good. This is just like random stuff. I need a scissors. Like, why do I only ever have scissors with zigzags? Where are my normal scissors? So I'm just going to cut a bunch of squares. Feel free to do this as well. Or you can just grid up some stuff in your sketchbook or your piece of paper, whatever you have. And I'm not going to be too... I'm not going to be too, like, I don't know, worried about how straight they are. Let me just curl up on my little chair here. Yeah. I downloaded a pixel art app today, so I was going to try and make the drawings on here, but I can't figure out how to open the gallery on Odani. I think I'm going to draw either a gratitude-inspired cabinet or a fall one. Oh, amazing. Amazing. I do have a bunch of reference photos we can use, and a lot of those reference photos have multiple items on them. So I was thinking we could do like 2 minutes per drawing, just for fun. Fun and speed. And then, what else was I saying? Oh, and because there's multiple images on each, like, image, you can choose which one you want. So I'm gonna do some, like, all different shapes. Some long ones, some little ones. That way it'll be fun to like puzzle them all together, I think. Maybe some wide ones as well. I guess I can put these long or wide. Interactive. Feeling very interactive today. Let's do some small ones too. Yeah, so we can do a bunch together. And then if you want to expand your cabinet of curiosities, you can always do some more a bit later by yourself. I'm not sure how many I'm going to do. I'm just going to do cut a few more, maybe some bigger ones, a couple of big ones. And we'll see how we go. So these are going to be my little cabinet shelves. Put my sketchbook away. Look at that. There we go. Fun things. I'm just going to make sure you can see me. Yes, you can. Good. Thanks, Caitlin. Thanks, Sophia. I hope it comes together. We'll see what happens. Go on with colours. Where's my pencil sharpener? I was a bit late this morning, so I'm not very prepared. Sorry. I swear I just had my pencil sharpener. Oh, there it is. Alrighty. Let me know if the music's too loud or if it's too soft or anything. Why am I tempted though to do ink? No, we're gonna stick with pencil. I'm gonna stick with pencil. I've got my timer. Where's my timer? Here it is. Okay. Now, there we go. There's our idea of a cabinet. We can always come back to these and like do some drawings in here as well. So I put everything like really random. So I'm not even sure what order of everything is. So we're just going to scroll through it. I can also at the end of the stream, don't let me forget, I can put a link to the Pinterest board that I've gathered all these items to, so you can go back and look at it later. And if there's an artist or something that you want to go back and look at more of, you can do that via my Pinterest. Yeah. Fistfight Cupcake, that's a great username. Welcome to Scribble Brigade. I'm glad the music is good. Debbie says, I used to have an old vintage Coca-Cola crate and I used it as a curio cabinet for my Beatrix Potter figurines as a kid. Oh, my heart. Okay. Let me just sharpen a couple of things before we get too far ahead of ourselves, because none of my pencils are sharp. I wonder if I should bring my microphone a bit closer to me. There we go. It's, the spring is happening here in Melbourne. So the weather is lovely. I'm so excited to be able to, like, go outside again and do some drawing and, I don't know, more walkies, more picnics with the doggies, more everything. I mean, I love winter. I'm a massive winter person. Love being cold. Hey, baby. Hey, baby, how are you? How are you? You saying hello? She's gonna knock everything. Okay. I think that'll do for a few colors for now. I can always sharpen as I go. Latte honey, it's your first Scribble Brigade too, yay! Marianne, me too, took me a bit to figure out time difference. Can we go backwards too? Like, what? it's only very hot here, but it rained today. Oh, I love rain on a hot day. Thank goodness for YouTube reminder notifications. It's so hard. And because Australia has, Melbourne has daylight savings, I never remember which daylight saving it is, like what the code for it is. So I'm always just like, Melbourne time. Melbourne time will do. Okay. Moo, hello, welcome. And Len Gray. Oh, it's so nice that there are so many new faces here. All right, shall we begin? Shall we begin? Let's begin. Intergalactic Peach Patrol, hello. Okay. All right, we're going to begin. So I've got a 2-minute timer, so we're going to do 2 minutes. That might be too much time for things, or it might not be enough time for things, but either way, challenge accepted. Let's go. The first thing we're going to be drawing is key. So you can choose one key, you can choose multiple keys. I'm going to quickly grab out a piece of paper and start the timer. Let's just go for it. I kind of like this clover-esque key on the left. And yeah, this is just also meant to be playful and just a way to do a fun art game with pals. One of my favorite things is parallel play, drawing with people, like, quietly. It's one of my favorite ways to spend time with my friends. Love vintage stuff so much. Like, I don't know, it was always beauty before function, right? And it doesn't seem like that as much now. Maybe it's coming back a little bit more, but yeah, I just love the beauty of old stuff. So I'm gonna try and like make this semi gold looking. I started with like a green ochre. I'm gonna just throw some yellow in. I'm being quite messy. I don't wanna be too perfection here. 47 seconds to go. If you're doing what I'm doing and like cutting out a bunch of paper, or even just like doing grids, you can like give each little square dimension by doing, you know, like a little 3D kind of situation. So it looks like it's going in. Does that make sense? Ten seconds. There we go. 2 minutes. This is my first little key. We're just gonna like steamroll ahead because we've got a lot to do. Next one. Butterflies. Again, choose one, choose many. Maybe we can do two different butterflies here. I'm gonna do a big one. Let's go. So let's start with one butterfly for this timer and then we can do another one as well. This little guy with the little orange spots, I love. And yeah, if 2 minutes is too speedy for you, I mean, you can always come back. Oh, this song is quite stressful. You can always come back if you wanna. And continue your drawing, so don't worry if you don't finish it. Or if it's really terrible, we can all decide to add another minute or two to our timer. It'll be cool if YouTube did something similar to what Twitch does, where you can say, like, you can redeem things. That'll be fun, be able to redeem an extra minute. 1 minute and 5 seconds to go on this one. Plenty of time. I think it helps to draw quite small because then you don't have to do as much detail. Maybe I'll keep to a color palette, I don't know. Who knows anything ever. Twenty-nine seconds. We can have a break after like a few and have a step back and a look and a drink and a refuel. You know what I want to do? I might do a little bit of a shadow situation so it looks like it's sitting on top of the cabinet. You know how bugs like get pinned down? There we go, little shadow. Cute! Will you do the same key? Fun. You're joining from Orlando, Florida. First time, fingers crossed my kiddo stays asleep. Adventures of M&M. I love it. Let's do another butterfly. All right. Pick your butterfly or moth. Let's do another 2 minutes. I don't know what to do. I'm gonna do number... I don't know, what's everyone else doing? I'm gonna do one, I think. Love butterflies, but I can't help but scream if they go on me. It's just like human reaction. I think I'm gonna get a little bit illustrative as well, like I'm not going super realistic. There's quite a lot in this butterfly. Simplify. All this music is from like my YouTube videos. And so when I hear it, I'm like, oh, that was from when I did this video, and that's from this video. Funny. Uh, 53 seconds to go. I'll try and get this dark patterny things in so I can do some color. Okay, just let me know if it's annoying that I'm talking or if you'd prefer me to be quiet. Probably as the stream goes on, I'll get more and more quiet because I'll get more and more sick of hearing my own voice. 20 seconds. There we go. Okay, didn't quite finish that guy. Let's just sneak in a quick shadow. Cute. Oh my god, not please talk, whichever is nice. Oh, thank you. This seasonal transition has my sleep all out of whack. I'm so tired. My doodles are all a bit wonky. Agreed. Relatable. I'm feeling like a bit hay fevery, like I'm feeling a bit clogged. Oh, you like hearing me talk? That's nice. Yay, we got some ladybugs. Let me zoom out a wee bit. Is that too much? Let me just fix that. All right, choose one and let's go. 2 minutes. Is that okay? Let me just... No, that's all good. Yeah. Okay, 2 minutes, let's go for it. The thing is choosing. I like the full yellow one, that's nice. On the right. Bugs are the coolest and the cutest little guys. I love them. Especially these kind of like ladybug kind of things. I love ladybugs. So magical looking. Mine's just a little baby. Just a little baby. I've got friends who like say that about that. They've got a little chihuahua. They always say, "We're not baby." In like a silly aggressive voice, and it's just part of my everyday vocabulary now. Well, baby. A little bit of shadow, so it looks like he's sitting inside like a shelf. 45 seconds to go. How are you all going with it? Are you enjoying the speediness? You don't have to respond now because I know we're all drawing. Or is it too fast? Or is it just right? Remember, the point is to like be loose and just do silly stuff. 13 seconds. Bug I chose was very easy. Very little. Just a wee little baby. Okay, there we go. Let's do another bug. Another ladybug. I think I might have to cut more paper. We'll see. Okay, choose your next one. Oh, thank you, Sue. You like the talking? It makes me feel like it's a hangout. Yes, good. Thank you, Fistfight Cupcake. I love your username, it's so funny. Okay, next buggy. I think I'm gonna do orange in the bottom middle. That's my guy. Yeah. Good thing about drawing bugs is you don't have to do it perfectly because they all just look buggy. The speed is good. Okay, good. 2 minutes seems good for me. I'm just doodling away with pen. This is my first time and I'm a learner drawer, so the 2 minutes is really fun. Oh, that's awesome. Great, great, great. Yeah, I like 2 minutes. I think 2 minutes is a really happy kind of number. Like, it's enough to be loose, but it still also, like, allows you to be, you know, you can still get enough detail in. 57 seconds to go. Cute. I like this guy. 25 seconds. Ten seconds. There we go. Cute. What have we got next? Lily, hello. Oh, thank you, honey. I'm going to call you honey because I think that's the cutest name. But I really need you to tell me how to pronounce your name correctly. Send me a voice message because I feel terrible. Honey. Honey? Yeah. Anyway. Good. Good, good. Let's go to the next one, which is a vial of mushrooms and moss and ferns and stuff. Let's draw one. Quickly get a long piece out. There we go. All right, ready, Freddy? Let's go. Just choose one. And, like, it doesn't have to be perfect. You can interpret it any way you want. Like, I know there's a lot of information going on here. But just, like, minimize, like, just do whatever you need to do to get through this. 2 minutes have started. I've got a couple of images of, like, vintage bottles and vials of things because I love that. I love those things. I love the way the glass makes those little, I don't know, makes the cork inside look all wild and interesting. Fun. Dirt. Oh, there's some like water in some of them. I like the mushrooms too. There's some mushies. Turn it into our own rather than copying every little element, I think is the way to do it. Just gonna do some like blobs and stuff. 50 seconds. I'm scribbling. My desk is like, you probably can't hear it. Some like leaf stuff going on here. Kind of just making it up at this point. Giving it a shadow again. Just a vague one. 6 seconds. Yay. Cute. Everyone calls me Honey, but I'll send you a voice memo. Thank you. I do like the name Honey. All right, next one. Similar vibe. Need some like longer pieces of paper. Maybe after this one we'll take a quick break because I need to cut some more slightly like long pieces of paper for, because this situation is not very good. Okay, 2 minutes, my friends. Let's go. Didn't leave enough space for the lid anyway. I'm making it smaller. It's like a little screwed in lid. That's cute. Some of these things like look vintage, but I don't know if they actually are. Could be. I mean, the glass vials definitely are, but the things inside probably not so much, because I doubt they would still be alive if they were around for many years. Kind of just like blurring my eyes a little bit and doing it that way rather than drawing specific things. Does that make sense? Although I learned the other day that not everyone can blur their eyes on command, so I don't know anything anymore. 51 seconds. Cute. Thirty-five. 20 seconds. I do wish there were some better, like, cartoony kind of greens, like this green in Prismacolor. All right, let's have a quick break. And I'm just going to cut a few more bits of paper. Lily says, I have a friend called Honey Jo and her sister is Angel. So cute. I think those are doorstops for the lid. Oh yeah. Yeah. Doorstops for the lid. Yeah, for sure. I can stay on this view. You can continue to draw your vials if you want. If you want to cheat. No, it's not cheating. It's fine. I feel like I need... Do I need another piece or should... I'll just keep my scissors on hand if I need to adapt. The size of anything. I feel like... Let's just cut this guy in half. Okie dokie. Debbie, see you, Deb. Thanks for coming. I believe that most males cannot blur their eyes, which is crazy to me. It's a superpower. Really? I gotta head off, but I'll finish on the replay. Thanks so much for the scribble fun. Bye, Debbie. Cool. How are we all feeling? All stretched? Get your water. Have a sip. Prepare some more squares. Look at what we've got so far. Really fun. I'm gonna stick these in my sketchbook, I think. Cute. It's gonna be fun, like, trying to arrange them in an interesting way. My doodles are cute. I love the bugs. Yes, love the bugs too. The kiddo has not stayed asleep and keeps popping her head in to ask if she can draw too. Oh, cute. It's too fun to not join in. Shall we proceed? Shall we continue? I think we shall. We can come back to bottles. I've got some more images, but I'm just gonna, let's do something different now. We've got acorns. Let's do some acorns. Let's go for it. Hi, Sarah. Hi, Sarah. Welcome to the chat. Welcome, welcome. Okay, let's draw some of these guys. And thanks for subscribing, Sarah. Yeah, I've got subscribers only for chatting. I don't know why, just did. I'm using a sketchbook I handmade with watercolor and it's so satisfying. Why haven't I done this before? Oh, I want to see. I want to see. I'm currently sitting in a tree and I just dropped my green. Lily, you're just magical. The green is gone now. The green is gone. Okay, 2 minutes. Let's choose an acorn and draw it. Maybe we can do a couple of acorns. How does that sound? You can even do a couple acorns within your little square. Is it upside down? They're all kind of upside down. Did I put the timer on? Yes, 1:55 to go. How cute are acorns? Literally like a fairy's item. One minute 30. I need more browns. Oh well, we just don't have brown today very much. We create brown with other colors. And layering and eye optical illusions. My drink bottle is making a weird noise. Also, if you're asking me something in chat and I don't see it and I start responding to other ones, just say it again because it's hard to sometimes keep track. 16 seconds. That's a cute little guy. Sarah says, I've been subscribed for ages and it wouldn't let me chat because apparently I subscribed while I was watching kids' content. So I had to resubscribe. Oh, well, I'm glad you figured it out. I took a picture of a tree's first ever acorn last week. It's a little sapling and it felt ridiculous. I felt ridiculously proud of it. Cute. One of my friends told me last night that he's never seen an acorn in person. He didn't know we had them. The Emerald Lake, they have a bajillion acorns, don't they? Go there with them. All right, let's draw another acorn because they're freaking adorable. Let's go. I'm going to draw this little green fella on the second bottom row. Yeah, you can, was I thinking this or did I actually say it already? I grabbed a couple of acorns when I was at the Emerald Lake last, and you put them in sand and water and put them in the fridge for like many weeks. It was so many weeks. A lot of weeks, and when they started little sprouting, you plant them and then they started doing leaves. It's like taken like 3 years for them to get this big, so I'm probably not doing it right, but very exciting.
make it our own little oakies. I like being a bit more playful with my shape application at the moment. It's like a bit more painterly, I think. Fun. Uh, 40 seconds. I'm sorry if I keep forgetting to time. Does anyone remember Okie Doke, the Akon dude on ABC? Yes, vaguely. I vaguely do. Remember that you don't have to draw for the entire 2 minutes. Like, if you feel like you're done, you can stop early and it's fine. Because sometimes we overwork and we don't want to overwork anything. Okay. I don't know if, I think Okie Doke, I don't know if I really watched that, but yeah, cute name. All right, now we've got this one, collection of leaves and feathers and seed pods and stuff. So let's draw some of those. Choose what you want to do. I feel like these big ones, I'm not really using them. Anyway, we'll continue. yeah, maybe we can do two from this spread. We're definitely going to go over our 1 hour, but that's okay. I'm having too much fun to stop. Ready? 2 minutes on the clock, on the rocket clock. This is so fun, but also stressful. My perfectionism is trying to... No perfectionism allowed. No, gone. Out with it. Just have fun. Like, you know, remember when we were kids and we used to have fun doing things? Making art? It's like that. We're being silly. Also, you can always come back and redo. I'm drawing these little, like, poppy pods in the bottom right. They're really cute. Very cute. I planted a bunch of my poppy seeds at the beginning of winter, but none of them worked. There's too much, like... too much weeding to be done, and I think the weeds just overtook everything. It's a bit hard to see what's going on in this image. Maybe that it's good. Maybe the fact that it's like hard to see a lot of the details makes us be a little less hard, a little less perfectionism, a little less hard on ourselves or something. Kind of like got a bluish green thing going on. Seconds to go. I'm having the same impulse. This is fun. I'm glad. Same thing happening to me in primary school, but with the cicada shells. Ah, yes. Cicada shells, so fun. I used to love collecting them when I was little. My partner is not Australian. He's only been here for like 5 years or so. And when we went for a walk, he saw his first cicada shell just like sitting on someone's fence. And I stuck it on him. We used to wear them as brooches and stuff in primary school. Anyway, he got a big fright. Whoopsies. Terrible girlfriend. I planted mine 2 weekends ago and mine have started sprouting double peony poppies, really hoping they survive the snail infestation. Yes! So many snailies. Too many snailies. That's very exciting. They're so beautiful in our gardens. Okay, let's do another one from this cluster of goodies. I'm going to do a leaf. It's like a little oak leaf up the top there. Very cute. Nice and wonky. Your weeds killed your poppies. No, I think that's probably what's happening to me, Vera. The weeds are too powerful. And I have been a bit too lazy or too busy. I've been too busy, I should say. I shouldn't say lazy. I'm definitely not lazy. Been too busy to do anything about it. Cute. Let's get some black. Well, I don't use black. What's this? 90% grey. Nice and painterly. 33 seconds on this one. Christmas beetle shells were more precious than opals to us, like magical currency. Yeah. It was always so amazing when you'd find one. I remember finding living Christmas beetles and protecting them by capturing them and keeping them in a cage. Thinking that I was doing a good thing by looking after them. Yay! Okay. Where did they? I've seen Christmas beetles. Every so often there's like an infestation of them and they're everywhere. But they definitely felt like they were more around when we were kids. Okay, what have we got here? Let's do one of these ones. Oh, there's a thistle, a feather, some driftwood, some rocks, some marbles or bullets? What are they? Some glass and the fern thing on the left. We all know what I'm going to do. I'm going to do the thistle. Okay. 2 minutes, let's go. I'm going to try and make it have a bit more color than what it seems to have here. I don't know if these are actually called thistles, but they're like some sort of thistle adjacent thing. Thistles are a bit different. I have to go because I have an appointment and I'll watch the replay later and finish up my Curio cabinet. Bye, Lily! It was so good to see you. I love that you were in a tree. Makes me very glad. 1 minute to go. this like project or this Scribble Brigade reminds me of I don't know, like a high school project or something, or like a primary school project, and I'm loving it. One thing I miss about school or education is the fact that someone's like, this is what you're drawing. You don't really have to think too much because I've just told you what to draw. Now draw it. Cute, I like that one. I think we're just more observant as kids. One thing I used to see a lot when I was a child was like those tiny, tiny, tiny little minuscule red spiders, or there was some sort of bug thing, but they looked kind of spidery. I used to see them all the time, and I rarely see them as an adult these days. Same, I love the community of a school. Yeah. That was fun. Okay, next. I hope you're all having a good time. We're not even halfway through everything. Let's just keep going. Let's draw an acorn. Acorn time. All right. Let's go. Smashing it. Bloody smashing it. I'm gonna draw this funny little one. Top right. Little spiky. These are hard, okay. These are difficult to draw because there's a lot of information going on and our brains are like, where is the pattern to this? Why do I not understand all these shadows? Going a bit more illustrative with this one, I think. Love that like orange, that orangey brown color, which I don't have out. It must be somewhere over there in my pile of other things, other art supply things. Mine's just looking like a pile of scribble triangles. That's all right though. I think just like playing and doing weird experiments and not knowing what you're doing, it makes you realize like, yes, this does work, or no, that definitely does not work and I'm never going to do that ever again. And that's like the beauty of playing and making mistakes and giving yourself time limits. And it also like makes you not think too much, huh? There we go. That's time. We just give him a little shadow, quickly. No one's watching. Here we go. A lot of orange in my one. Moving on. I'm gonna speed up a little bit. There used to be heaps of butterflies at the time when I was a kid. Sad that they're rare now. I love your pencil drawing, Sophie. I might have to crack my pencils out and have a play later. I might need your beetles as some stickies. They're these little guys. Yeah, cute. Thanks, Peachy. Let's draw a lock. The padlock thing. Gosh, we're going from organic to metal to glass. We're pushing it today. Aren't we? Definitely feel like I used to see a lot more like big orangey butterflies when I was little. Love all the colors in these rusty, it's like purples and blues. So fun. And the green, like the, is that like when the copper kind of does stuff? It like goes kind of green. 1 minute and 8 seconds to go. Just like getting a bit speedy now with this one. Thank you all for being here. I was worried that this one would kind of not land. Like people would be like, I don't know what the heck she's talking about. I'm not going. I'm glad you're here. Uh, 25 seconds, I'm definitely not gonna get this done. Get real messy. I'm probably gonna abandon this one, and that's fine. We're allowed to abandon our drawings that we don't like. There's no rules. Oh no. Pencil break. 6 seconds. Yeah, this is not gonna be done. I can come back to it. Rusty look. Okay, I'm just gonna like put that one quite far away from everything else. Thank you for hosting. It's super refreshing and helping me out of a funk. Good. I'm so glad. I'm so, so glad. Oh, we got some pretty little like perfume bottles. Let's do a cute little perfume bottle together. Okay. I kind of want to do another key as well. They were nice. 2 minutes. One thing we used to do in our art hang before it became Scribble Brigade, I used to jump onto Discord and like show the stream what everyone's been doing, if you're comfortable with sharing, and that was always really nice. I think I'd like to bring that back to Scribble Brigade at some point. It's fairly easy to do. I can do it on the YouTube thing situation. I'm just talking to myself now. But yeah, I always enjoy doing that. Seconds to go. Loving drawing all these bottles and vials and stuff. These are really fun. There we go, that's the timer. Shadow real quick. Cute. Got another little vial. Lily of the Valley. Running out of paper again. Just gonna shove everything into a mist. All right, 2 minutes, let's go, pals. Look at that little stopper, that's super cute. This one's a lot, has a lot of details going on. Damn. 1 minute 15. I keep like glimpsing myself in the webcam thing and I'm hunching so bad. Everyone, posture. Uh, 44 seconds. It's hard, this one. Okay, there we go. Cute. Looks good from far away. From up close, it's just like a messy thing, which is still cute. Okay, what have we got now? Oh, combs. I love vintage combs. I've got this like slight mini obsession with vintage combs. They're beautiful. They are so beautiful. Yeah, combs. Beautiful, vintage, love. can we add more miniatures to this one? It's super cool. I've got, okay, just you wait, I've got some good ones coming up after this, some like miniature toys and a teapot and stuff. So let's get into it. Let's do a comb. 2 minutes. Did I press timer? Yes. I'm just gonna be nice and messy here, I think. I love this. Vintage combs. So pretty. I'm basically just making you all draw the things that I love. $1.28. I also collect very tiny spoons. I love them. The smaller the better. I guess I've just kind of ended up making up my own little comb. It's not really exactly like anything in the images. Sort of, not really. 47 seconds. Twenty-5 seconds. Love it.
5 seconds. Definitely need more paper if we're gonna keep going. Let's just cut this one. This one. Okie dokie. Let's take a quick little break. I need to sharpen some pencils. We've done a few. We've been here for an hour now, drawing, or slightly over an hour. Let's go for a little bit longer. If you're over too long, you sort of get bored or tired and... Oh no, and it's not as fun anymore. Spilled all my pencil shavings. Onto the floor they go. for a vacuum up later. Possibly they will stay there for 3 days. Is that the same one? Yeah, I don't need to sharpen that one. Sorry, just give me a secchi. Wow, did YouTube really just delete my comment? Oh, what did you say? There is nothing there. Okay, I think that'll do for the sharpenings. Actually, I need this one to be sharpened. This tiny little one. All right, are you ready? The next one, we've got some cute little porcelain doggies. Let's go. Ready? I said before I was rudely interrupted that I just cracked out some hummus and chippies and nom-nommed on while I drew and chilled, and it was lovely. Oh, that is absolutely perfect. Let's draw a little doggy. Okay, I'm gonna draw this little Jack Russell because he's too cute. Or is he a little foxy thing? Little fox terrier, maybe? I made his leg too thick. To kind of make it look porcelain, I guess, maybe, not really. Cute, cute little guy. Maybe some blue will make it look kind of porcelain. That little tail. Forty seconds. I did mine very quick. Let's just add some dark. I'm blowing the little pencil bits, that's why you're probably hearing me blowing all the time. Three seconds. Cute. All right, let's go to the next one, which is another toy. I love him. Okay, don't say anything about my child. He looks like he's about to cry. So cute. All right, let's do this one. So weird. Okay. Don't know what the heck
is happening with his dog, but it's the best. The big ribbon, oh, amazing. Do you reckon it's a borzoi? I think it's meant to be a borzoi. Don't cry, borzoi. Love it so much. Being really scribbly, yeah. The laziness has kicked in and the scribbliness has taken over. Um, 12 seconds. Great, what a champion. classic Bambi. I need more paper. I mean, you can all sneakily, without me watching, start drawing the Bambi if you wanna. While I quickly cut a Bambi-sized piece of paper. Very wonky. Let's go. 2 minutes. Cute. They always did eyebrows like that, didn't they? On there. Cute characters. One minute 40. This song has been on like 4 times. The shine is so satisfying. Look at the shine on his forehead. Need a better brown. That'll solve so many things. I'm gonna get it. Oh, I stepped on something. Oh, yes, brown. I've got brown now. Happy. Ah, 30 seconds. Again, we can come back, or maybe we can add another minute onto this one. What do you think? I think I could benefit with an extra minute. What do you reckon, another minute on our Bambi? I'm just going to call it. About how often do you put these on? My girlfriend got home a bit ago and I'm torn between squeezing out as much art juice as possible or giving her snuggles. You'll be able to watch the replay of this afterwards, but I do these first, second and third Wednesdays of the month. But the first and third Wednesdays are Patreon only, and second Wednesday of the month is public. All right, an extra minute. Let's do it. Because I feel like I barely did anything. Yay, good job everyone. That was a difficult one. Hi Lullabelle. Lucky we're still here. We usually only go for an hour, but we're going for a longer one because we got a lot of drawings to draw today. Just gonna cut up. Oh no, I've got ink on my scissors. Alrighty, what have we got next? We got this bunny. Should we draw this bunny real quick? 2 minute bun. Let's go. He's cute, look at him. His silly little face. Precious bunny. It's like a little cast iron friend. These cute little legs. I never got into rabbits when I was little, but for some reason I've been just obsessed with them lately. Oh, his eye placement, I love it so much. So cute. Oh, I only had it on 1 minute. Hang on. We've got another minute to go. Wait, pause, stop. One more minute to go. That's what I was thinking. I was like, it cannot have been 2 minutes. Okay, 1 minute to go. Seconds. Come on, brain. Just a cute little bunny guy. Love him. Wish I got the eye prop like better in my drawing. That's all right. 5 seconds. Cute guy. I said a reminder, but I was sucked into a project. Yes. Len Gray heading out, y'all. I had a lot of fun. Bye, friend. Bye, friend. Bye, friend. I've got a ton more. I've got a ton more to do. Brain. Okay, let's use words. I've got a ton more saved on the Pinterest. But I think we should just do like, I don't know, 5 more. I'm getting a bit tired. But I will link the Pinterest here. Also, I can link the Pinterest on Patreon. I've got a public post which anyone can look at, talking about this stream that's happening right now, and I can attach the link to the Pinterest board to that, so you can go have a look and draw, redraw, do more, whatever you want to do. So I'll do that after the stream is done. Look at this. Let's do one of these. I love it. I love it. I'm gonna do a teapot, little teapot. No, I'm gonna do a little cup, I think. Okay, 2 minutes on the timer. Let's go. Which way do I want it to be? This way, maybe. They are unnerving. I love them. I love weird vintage stuff like this. Just the best. Absolutely best ever. Got like Cupid doll faces. Look at the little love heart mouth. I am inspired. Where's red for that little love heart mouth? There's something about like the placement of features as well in these vintage old times that I love. I don't have the exact green, but I'm gonna layer. I've got this like, what's this one called? Like a turquoisey one. And then I'll layer a more appley green on top of it. 43 seconds. Do the green of the eyes there. Layer this one on. Break it in the process. Get these eyes in. My goodness. It's so silly. Oh no, I think we need a little more time, don't we? Just 1 minute, one more minute. I'm breaking my own rules. This is the problem. The longer we go on, the more you want to spend on a drawing. They've even got like little nose dots, which I didn't see at first. Where's that colour? A little bit of shadow. Okay, I'm done. I'm done. As I continue to draw, I'm done. That's so dumb. It's the dumbest thing I've ever drawn. Okay, while you're finishing that one. Some cute things here I'm enjoying. I like the acorns and I like the key. This thistly thing. The dogs. Some good ones. Butterfly's nice too. The teapot looks like my great auntie. I've got this one. I've got this one here, but I don't think we'll draw this one. I can leave that one up to you. I do have some fun brooches with eyes painted in them, which was a thing that they used to do back then, which maybe we can attempt one of these. What do you think? I think we should. And I don't know the exact history of these eye brooches or eye charms, but maybe it's like looking over you kind of thing. Anyway, let's try it out. 2 minutes. Starting now. Okay. This is one of those ones you can probably spend a while on. I'm just gonna go fast. Gold. I'm doing the pearly one. Oh, they're all multiple pearly ones. Anyway, top left. Ah, oh, I only had 1 minute on, sorry. I keep changing the timer. Lovers' eye portraits, they were for people who couldn't afford to get full portraits painted of their loved ones. They would just commission an eye. So nice, so romantic. I don't know how to like draw pearls really quickly. Thanks for looking that up, Caitlin. Creepy. Okay. I think it's been 2 minutes, hasn't it? I think I put an extra minute on. Oh, well, lucky you. You get an extra minute. This, I don't know. I think I'm coming to the end of my botheredness to draw. There we go. An eye brooch, that's fun, which I did terrible shading on. Love it. How many have we done extra now? We've done 2? I said we'd do 5. Let's do 3 more then. I have some cute, another teapot. What do we reckon? Cute little teapot. Let me just... I need more of a square. Okay.
Okay. Teapot. Let's do it. Oh, thank you, Peachy. I'm glad you like it. Let's do this one. And then two more after this. I definitely have a teapot very similar to this. Okay, so if speed up, I keep getting sucked into doing too much detail. We're gonna speed it up, full blown ahead. Good words. This yellow is such a lovely yellow. I'm gonna go in and do some negative space daisies here, which means I just do the outline and color in the background rather than, like, I don't know, not getting too fancy with it. Keeping it painterly, I guess, and it sort of makes you see what's there even though you haven't drawn the thing very precisely. You can still see it's there. That's why I love negative space, because it sort of alludes to more than what is actually there. I need to think about how to phrase that better, but yeah. Uh, 17 seconds. I keep forgetting to shout out the time. There we go, cute. Two seconds. Pretty. Two more. I've got this cute... I don't know if this is... Oh no, let's do this one of these. A scissors. There's a lot going on here, so it's a little difficult to see. But let's give it a go. Alright. Have a look at the scissors. Okay, let's do it. 2 minutes. Let's do scissors. I've got a long piece of paper, so I'm going to do a longer pair. Where's the pair I was looking at? They're gone. I do love a good pair of cute sewing scissors as well. Those little ones that look like a bird. Iconic in the household. This music matches the Curiosity Cabinet vibes, very like Amelie-esque. Okay, I'm gonna get my key out so I can see how I did the... Even though the image I am copying is like a black metal, I'm gonna change it to a gold or dark metal. 38 seconds to go. Okay.
The green. Three seconds. Just enough time for me to add in some shadow. So it looks like it's sitting on the shelf. Yay! One more, let's do one more. Now I've got another leaf. Okay, let's all choose. So I've got this ginkgo leaf, which is super cute. A cluster of buttons, also super cute. Or I've got like a brooch of a hand. Mega cute. What do you think? First person to answer gets it. Hand, buttons, ginkgo. Need to figure out what size I want to do. The brooch. We're doing the brooch. Good job, Julia. Let's do it. It's a tough one. We might need 3 minutes for this one. Let's go. Let's make it happen. Two minutes, and if we need a third minute, we'll chuck in a third minute. Go. It's beautiful and difficult. Ending on the most difficult one possible. Love it. A lot of shapes going on. Next song. This is too stressful. We've listened to that song so often. There we go. Thank you, Vera. I'm glad you liked this idea. I'm really, really glad you liked it. I was worried that no one would like it because it's a bit different to what I usually do. But it's fun. It's different in a good way. You'll have to do the ginkgo in your own time later. I do like the ginkgo as well. Super cute. 49 seconds. This is hard because it's like white or ivory. Rather than with colors. Oops, went off the page a bit. Let's add another minute, I reckon. This is one of those times where we need another minute. There we go. I've sort of changed mine a bit and squished it so it can fit on this piece of paper. Add in some cheeky blue, make it look something for unknown reasons. We've got a bit of shadow as well. 25 seconds. Yeah, I don't know. That was a hard one. I'm sure with like time and actual trying, it'll be better. Beautiful work, everyone. I think we're gonna stop it there for the drawing. I've got my sketchbook. Let's just like play with some arrangements. So I think I'm gonna stick them in here. I guess things can go any angle they want to be. There's my other bug. Try and put things together that are slightly unexpected. I don't know if you can really see what I'm doing too much. This brooch here. Well, the acorns are very cute. They're originally upside down, but I think I'm going to put them that way. Although maybe that way is upside down, and the ways I've always drawn acorns has been the right way, the wrong way, I mean. I'm even going to like cut a little bit off that one. Yeah, we'll see. Something like this. I'll spend more time on this after. It'll be nice to do a nice big spread. Somehow puzzle them all in. This cup is so silly. Yeah. Anyway, I think we can have fun with that at our own leisure, putting together our own little cabinet of curiosities. I don't know, you could do it in your sketchbook or in a new piece of paper. Whatever tickles your fancy, whatever floats your boat. Gonna have fun doing that for ages. Yeah. Cute. All right, everyone. That was a really fun session. I had such a good time. Look, I don't know if you can sort of see how it's going there, but yeah, I guess that's kind of my idea, is to stick them all around. Another thing you could do if you're sticking it in your sketchbook or on a piece of paper is you could paint the paper a different color, or like a brown or blue, whatever color you want your cabinet to be. And then that'll kind of work as a frame around each thing, so they're easier to see. Yeah, that's about it. I'm so glad you enjoyed. That was really fun. I really had a very good time as well. Something different, something unusual, and a bit silly. Good for our skills to keep fast, and yeah, lots of different things to keep us busy in the brain. Scratch our brains with challenges. So as I mentioned before, I do live streams 3 times a month. The first Wednesday of every month is a Patreon only one for the Orange Bird and Yellow Bird tiers. The second Wednesday of the month is a public one, which anyone can join in. And the third Wednesday of the month is another Patreon only tier, but I do it in the evening my time, which means that more people who are Europe UK based can join in as well, sort of. It's so hard to find the right time zones for everyone, but it has to work for me as well. So anyway, yeah, if you want more of this, like if you want this 3 times a month, definitely pop onto Patreon. But otherwise, I'll be here once a month and it'll be nice. You can also go back and look at this and draw more, or just like if you came late, or if you, you know, couldn't come see the end, do it. Now, I'm going to go onto Patreon, my Patreon page, the public post, which is promoting, or which is talking about this live stream that's happening right now. I'm going to go to that post and just add the Pinterest link, which you can go and you can have a look at all the images that we've drawn. And there's some more there as well, which we didn't get to draw, that you can add to your curio cabinet if you would like, or just spend more time on it here and there. Anyway, I'll do that now. And I will leave the link in the description if you're watching this on YouTube later. Good. Yay! I'm so glad I'm seeing lots of comments of cute. Everyone's being inspired and happy. Oh, I love you guys. Good. All right. Thank you so much for your support. Leave a comment as well on the YouTube video after this stops being live. I would love that. And let me know how your curio cabinet is going and which is your favorite one of the day. What was your favorite one to draw? I would love that. Thank you, everyone. So good to see your faces. Thanks for coming along. It was really fun. I adore you. See you patrons next week, and I'll see you next month for another live stream. Okay, bye.